A college campus is studying its parking lot usage. The number of cars parked in the lot was recorded each hour for one full day. Refer to the table of data that I had asked you to print. This table gives you the number of cars in the lot each hour during that day. Here's what the table looks like. Hopefully you have a copy that you can look at sitting beside you. There are two variables or two data types, the time of day and the number of cars in the lot at each of those times. In algebra, this is called a relation. In this example, the number of cars in the lot is related to the time of day. This relation is a special type called a function, and in this activity, you will discover why. The two variables in a function can always be identified as input and output. In a relation, one variable is designated as the input and the other as the output. The value of the input variable is listed first. The output value is determined by the given input value. In our example, the time of day is designated as the input variable, and so its values are in the first column. The number of cars in the parking lot is designated as the output variable, and its values are in the second column. Answer this question. For an input of 6 p.m., how many cars are in the parking lot? Look at your table. Look at the column of input, time of day, and find 6 p.m. Now find the related data element, which is the output, the number of cars. Got it? For an input of 6 p.m., there are 427 cars in the parking lot, and that is the output. Now we will define a function. If each input value in a relation corresponds to exactly one output value, then it is a function. If it's a function, we can say it verbally this way. The output variable is a function of the input variable. Does our parking lot relation represent a function? To determine this, we must check to see if for each input, which is the specific time of day, is there one and only one output? Look at the table. Look at the time of day. 7 a.m., there are 24 cars. At 8 a.m., there are 212. If you look down the first column, the time of day, you will see each time is different. And across from it, there is only one value. There's only one output for each input. So the conclusion is that this relation is a function. And so we can say verbally, the number of cars in the lot is a function of the time of day. Remember, we say the output variable is a function of the input variable. And so we say the number of cars in the lot is a function of the input, which is time of day. So in summary, each input has one unique output value if something is a function. If any one input value has more than one output value, then it is not a function. For example, if at 9 a.m. there were 384 cars in the lot, and there was another 9 a.m. with 402 cars in the lot, then the relationship would not be a function. If you interchange the input and output in this parking lot relation, then do you still have a function? Is the time of day a function of the number of cars in the lot? Here's our original table. Think about the columns being switched and the number of cars being the input. Look down that column, the number of cars. Do you see any duplicates? One that I notice is 384. There are 384 cars at 9 a.m., at 1 p.m., and at 7 p.m. So if we reverse our input and output, if the number of cars is our input, then it does not point to one and only one output, at least for the input of 384. So no, if we interchange the input and output in this relation, we would not have a function. Because for the input value of 384, there are three corresponding output values, 7 p.m., 1 p.m., and 9 a.m. Time of day is not a function of the number of cars.